Hello, this is Greg Olson. I'm TSI's Senior Industrial Hygienist and the Global Product Manager for the Health and Safety Instrument line here at TSI. Welcome to another in a series of product training videos. Today we're going to be going over the DustTrack DRX, which is similar to the DustTrack 2 in menu format. What we're specifically going to do today is go through how to program a DustTrack 2 or DRX to sample either in survey mode, which is a non-logging mode, or manual logging mode, which is a quick setup mode for logging, and a program log mode, which is a much more detailed sample program that can be run for extended periods of time or to be able to conduct multiple samples. Now, across the bottom of a DustTrack 2 or DRX, you have a row of tabs, function tabs. You've got the setup tab, the run mode tab, the data tab, the graph tab, and a main tab. We're in the main screen right now, which was actuated by the main tab. What we're going to do is go over to the run mode tab, and I'm going to select that. Now, I'm going to pull out our handy dandy stylus, and I'm going to go up here to the upper drop down menu. The upper drop down menu shows three different types of logging. You've got survey, manual log, and program log modes. There are six program log modes that you can access, and a manual and a survey mode. Survey is you just want to take data, you're not recording anything. So let's look at setting up for survey mode. In survey mode, you've got two different things that you can set. Do you want to turn the instrument on immediately on startup? And what is your time constant? Typically, I like to run 10-second time constants. Now, what's a time constant? Time constant is the rate at which the screen is going to update during survey mode sampling. So what it amounts to is it's a 10-second rolling average of concentration. Very similar to what you might find on an old analog sound level meter that has a fast and a slow response. All we're doing is extending out the time that the unit has been looking at data to give us a more stable reading. You could have a time constant set from 1 second to 1 minute. I typically like the 10 seconds because it gives us nice stable reading. So that's set at 10 seconds. All we simply do is click back up here, and we can literally go back to the main page and we can start sampling by hitting the start button. And now we're in a survey log mode and we're looking at 10 second time constants. I'm going to hit the stop button and I'm going to go back to the run mode. Now I'm going to click on the upper drop down menu again, and I'm going to look at manual logging. In manual logging, I've got a couple of other things that we're going to look at. We've got test length, all right? We've got log interval and time constant. Now, again, our time constant, let's make that 10 seconds. And hit the save button. And then log interval. Log interval and time constant are completely different from each other. A log interval is what rate do you want to capture data during a sampling event. Rule of thumb is if you're going to sample over long periods of time, let's say it's an 8-hour work shift, you'd want to sample at roughly a 1 minute log interval. At an 8-hour log or shift, you'll actually have 480 data points, 480 minutes of sampling, plenty of data to be able to analyze to take a look at any exposure issues. Now, if you're going to sample for short periods of time, you're going to sample for 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 30 minutes, you definitely want to go with shorter log intervals so that you have more data points to look at. All right? The amount of data points is ultimately up to you. How much data do you want to have to analyze later on by looking at your raw data? Now, for a 5 or a 10 minute sample period, you may want to log every 15 seconds. Over a 5-minute period, every 15 seconds, that's 4 data points a minute, or over 5 minutes, 20 data points. You might want to go and reduce that to 5-second log intervals, okay, which will make that 12 data points a minute, or 5 times 12 is 60 data points. So it just kind of depends on what you want to do. All right, we'll leave that up to you. But a log interval, I'm just going to set that at 1 minute. And hit the save button. And now the test length. How long do you want to sample? Since I set a 1 minute log interval, I'm going to set the hours to 8 hours, 0 minutes, 0 days, and I'm going to hit save. And now I'm going to go back to the main menu. And if I turn this program on by hitting the start button, we will sample for an 8-hour period as soon as I hit the button, and we'll have 1 minute log interval data, and we're going to have a 60-second time, or excuse me, a 10-second time constant that is going to come up on the screen. Bear in mind, 10-second time constant data at 1 minute log interval will not be the same data. They will be different. Now let's go back and let's look at a more comprehensive logging program. Go to the upper drop-down menu, and I'm going to go to one of the other tests. Now, the nice thing about the program log mode is that you can actually name your test file. So I can get in here and I can put in a custom nomenclatured name, and I'm just going to use the backspace key, get rid of test one, and I'm just going to go www and hit save. Now that's my test program. Underneath here I have a lot of different program elements with which to work with. I have test length, log interval, number of tests. Now you could set up a custom program to run for a whole week. And let's go back to what we just programmed on the manual log mode. We programmed in a 1 minute log interval, an 8-hour shift sample period, okay, for test length. And now I could put in number 5 for 5 tests. And then down here under time between tests, what you would program in, because you're going to sample from say 8 in the morning till 5 in the afternoon, okay, or 4 in the afternoon, however you want to do this, you would go and program in that you're sampling for 8 hours, and then the time between the tests would be 16 hours, making up a 24-hour period. So time between tests would be 16 hours. You have some other log criteria down here where you can say when you want the test to start. You can name a date and a time. So let's say you want a sample to start at 9 o'clock in the morning, you want it to conclude at 5 o'clock in the afternoon, and you want it to run from Monday through Friday. So you would program in a test length of 8 hours, a log interval of 1 minute, number of tests 5, time between tests 16 hours, and then a start date of Monday, whatever that date may be, the calendar date, and then a start time of 900 hours, 0900 hours. All right, program that into the instrument. Go back to the main screen, and once you're here, you could go and program or hit that start button, and if it was, say, 7 o'clock in the morning, the instrument would go into a stasis mode for 2 hours until 9 a.m., and 1 minute before 9 a.m. at 8:59, the instrument will turn itself on automatically, the pump will warm up, the optics will warm up, and then at exactly 9 a.m., the instrument will start logging data for that 8-hour period, 5 times in a row, 5 sequential days under the program that you just initiated. So the DustTrack 2 and the DRX have a very complex programming capability. able to take care of your short-term or long-term sampling needs. This is Greg Olson with TSI. I hope this product training video has been informational. Thank you. Bye for now.